This is the smallest bird that man has ever reared. A biblical bird that has taken Ugandan farmers by storm as a result of its medicinal value, both in its meat and eggs. Jessica Nantare ventured into quail farming last year. She bought 1,500 quail eggs and hatched them. She was ready to start. The starting was not easy. Of the 1,500 eggs, she managed to take care of 280 birds only.
On my start, my husband sent me 1,500 eggs, and I took the eggs to the incubator for incubation. But at hatching, I got 435 birds. Now, the hardest part of it was the brooding, because I was doing it for the first time. I lost around 50 birds on the first day. And I felt, I started sweating. My pressure went up. I said, I'm going to lose all these birds and all this money in 1 week.
Without much experience and background knowledge of how to rear the small birds, Jessica's enterprise was not easy. The first challenge.
Fear within me, that's the first thing that made me lose all those birds. You know, with fear you will panic and you do what? So I started with those birds, 250, 280 that had remained. And they survived up to the third week, because mostly when they survive up to week three, it's very rare to lose them again.
Irrespective of the challenges, Jessica was determined to earn big from her quail farming venture.
From the 208 birds, how did you manage to expand to this
level? Now, from those birds, I really had to, after bringing the 280, I got the courage to do this thing again. And I sent for more eggs. I went back to the brooder. This time it was very successful. It gave me, you know, I didn't lose the birds I lost at first. I lost around, there were around 30 birds out of 1,000 and 500 that were in the brooder. So it gave me more courage. I started doing the expansion from there, and I started also selling to other farmers.
She expanded her enterprise, including doing brooding herself. She has bought incubators out of the enterprise. The brooding has ensured that she does not lose an egg and can be able to enable other farmers rare quails.
So the eggs will spend here, they will spend here 14 days in the incubator, then the 15th and 16th day they will go to the hatchery. That's a maximum of 18 days of incubation for the quail eggs.
Jessica Rabish's fears that quail farming might have been a pyramid scheme. She ascertains that the enterprise is a money-making corridor.
Right now I have around 3,000 birds, including the males and the females. And the market is just self-creating. This is something I always tell people. You know, there's been there was a discouragement somewhere in Kenya, I think, about the same birds. But I think it came from the farmers promising the people they sell birds to that they will do the marketing for them. Now, what I do, I always encourage people to do your marketing, because people need these eggs, people need the meat, but they just don't know where to get them.
Jessica terms quail farming as the easiest farming enterprise to venture in. It is less laborious and they don't feed a lot. Quails make noise when not fed properly. Unless they are satisfied, you will not be at peace.
These birds need food very early in the morning. At around 6, you're supposed to be feeding the birds, as early as that. And then it depends on the type of feeder that you're using. If you're using a very small feeder, they'll be making a lot of noise and telling you they need more food. They are not satisfied yet. Though it is known that after a quail is satisfied, it will not come back to food. It will relax a little bit. They are not like the chicken type, eh?
Though they don't get sick easily, you need to inspect them. Find out if they are in their mating season. Give them enough water. And indeed, from Jessica's point of view, they are small birds that will give you profits.
Don't want to stop.
Kenneth Bwire, WBS Smart Farming.